I was asked to write a poem that spoke of the unique place that railways have in our culture. As Nigel said, we wave at trains. It's the only form of transport that we wave at. I was asked to sum up how railways made in Britain changed this country and changed the world. To go on to salute the countless men and women whose energies and talents, many of them in this room this evening, keep the railways moving and thereby keep this country moving. And to pay particular tribute to some of the amazing contributions that we've heard this evening. It's my very great pleasure to share this with you now. I hope you enjoy it. It goes something like this. The railway children, Harry Potter, all the way to Hogwarts, Flying Scotsman, Brief Encounter, railways are our folklore. Ivy the Engine, Casey Jones, so many tales are told of Little Thomas Tank Engine, and yes, the Fat Controller. Is he here? You know who he is. The Polar Express to the Orient Express, and settle to Carlisle, and serious Trans-Siberian fans can settle back a while and read what Larkin, Auden and the poets had to say, or listen to the Hobo Blues from Freight Train USA, or John Lee Hooker, Elvis Presley's Train Songs of Our Youth, or watch Bond, James Bond, with countless villains fighting on the roof. Meet the train from Kansas City, but don't miss the last to Clarksville. On the midnight train to Georgia, he is leaving. Hearts will always burst with pride or hurt inside from stories, songs and tales of how a journey made in Britain made the world a world of rails. All aboard for a story of a vision and precision engineering of obsession, a succession of professionals all steering, all the pistons, all the engines, all the coal and soot and steam, all the motion, locomotion, the emotion, all the dreams. Through the valleys, over mountains, cutting tunnels, over plains, bringing people, bringing commerce, bringing trailblazers on trains, over prairies, over deserts, overcoming every test. And from sea to shining sea, the trains would tame the Wild West. Across Europe, across Asia, across decades it unfurled. It was railways, British railways, that would shape the modern world, changing Britain, changing Britons, changing how we live our lives. An injection of connection with a ticket bound to thrive. And the railways brought identity, prosperity to places. And the railways brought the horses and the people to the races. And the railways brought the fishing land to bring us our fish supper. And the railways brought the tea to make the old great British cuppa. And the railways brought the bounty of the planet to the shelf. And the railways brought the timetable. And thus brought time itself. And from yesteryear to this room here, the rail network today, it takes workers, dedicated workers, every moment, every day. And there's many people, unseen superstars, for whom rail is not just what they do. Rail is who they are. That's Nigel's line. And some of them are here tonight. For handshakes and high fives, I'm losing it now. The railway's not just livelihoods, but big parts of their lives. And at 2 a.m. and 4 a.m. and 6 a.m., they're out there. And on Christmas Day and Boxing Day and New Year's Day, they're still there, through the rain and through the snow and through the heat and in all weathers, under scrutiny and pressure, they still keep it all together. Some are high-vis, some are low-vis, at the station, at the junction, all are certain they are working so the nation can still function, so the workers get to work, and so the kids get home to mothers, so the fun seekers find some sun, and so the lovers meet with lovers. So in offices, in meetings, with their schedules, with their charts, with the history and the future of the railways in their hearts, and it's relentless, and it's thankless, and it's endless, and it's frustrating, oh, and everyone's an expert, but the train cannot keep waiting. It takes cooperation, dedication, and resolute resilience, and as seen tonight, a guiding light of engineering brilliance. And when things go wrong, they still stand strong, upholding public safety, with no fear to tread, but straight ahead, as in Manchester just lately. as in Manchester just lately, where they felt the blast, but got there fast, the first ones on the scene. We can't imagine. Shards and fragments and all that they have seen. A city bled, but then we said, we'll rise from where we've sank to. We stand together, choosing love, and Manchester says thank you. And when London Bridge was falling down, one man didn't hide. He was stepping up and stepping in, no thought to step aside. He was one man with a baton, fighting three men with their knives, and with no thought for his safety, buying time and saving lives. And with no thought for his safety, buying time and saving lives. And though stabbed and blinded, single-minded, still he battled on. And just as bravely, fighting daily, his battle still goes on. And we thank him this evening. And so he and others, railway brothers, sisters, all en route to this platform where tonight we say, your industry salutes you. And so much applause, with much good cause. Tonight we've seen the spirit of the railway and how railways people's spirit knows no limits. And that's as we've seen at Parsons Green. There's anger, fear, and sorrow. But the railway men and women will be back at work tomorrow. We salute them. They'll be back at work tomorrow, and we thank them. And there's challenges and differences, but nights like this can build and bring us all aboard. We stand, applaud. We all are railway children. Thank you. Thank you. I salute you. Thank you. Nigel, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.